You've probably heard a few of these things about bees. They're in danger, they're being poisoned by pesticides, they're spontaneously vanishing, they're going extinct. The plight of bees has been in the news for years now. Back in 2013, Time magazine asked us all to imagine, quote, a world without bees. In short, whatever you've heard about bees in the past decade, it's probably bad. So what is going on with bees? The truth is, they are in trouble, but maybe not the bees you're thinking of. Without bees, humans would have a serious food problem. Some 35% of crops around the world benefit from pollinators like bees. Without pollinators, everything from strawberries to chocolate to coffee would suffer. And of course, there's the honey. And there's one particular species, the Western honeybee, that farmers rely on all around the world. It's also probably what you'd just call a bee.
Yeah, generally when people think about bees, it is the Western honeybee.
This is Bernardo Nino. He's a researcher at UC Davis and head of R&D at a startup called UBees. Bernardo's quick to point out all the crops in America that benefit from honeybees.
Cherries, blueberries, apples, some avocados.
And some that we couldn't grow at all without honeybees.
Here in California, the almonds are a very important crop, and they essentially require honeybee pollination.
This all explains why it was big news when, starting in late 2006, beekeepers reported losing 30 to 90% of their colonies. For comparison, it's normal to lose more like 15 to 20% of colonies annually. The weirdest part is that the bees weren't all dying, they were just flying away. It was bad enough to warrant an official term.
Colony collapse disorder can be described as essentially all the adult bees, or most of the adult bees, leaving the colony, leaving the queen, healthy-looking brood, and that was part of the really stressful and confusing part is that the bees seem to just leave.
Colony collapse disorder, or CCD, broke into the national news.
Colony collapse disorder.
Colony collapse.
Colony collapse disorder.
Colony collapse disorder remains a mystery.
And for years now, we've all fretted about the beepocalypse.
Do you like to eat? Well, this next story is of concern to you.
In the years since 2006, we've learned a lot about CCD, but it's still a bit of a mystery.
There was a lot of funding thrown at research programs. There was never any particular one thing that was defined as the cause of CCD.
Instead, we've come to better understand the stresses that bees face. For example, entire colonies can fall victim to the Varroa mite, a stubborn parasite that's wreaked havoc on bees for decades. Certain pesticide chemicals called neonicotinoids can also be deadly. And viruses, poor nutrition, and habitat loss can take their toll as well. This mix of factors might be causing colony collapse disorder, but any one of them is a problem that needs addressing regardless of CCD. So, since 2006, beekeepers have upped their game to improve colony health, and it seems to be working. Numbers vary, but for the past couple years, the number of bee colonies lost in the US has been leveling off.
The silver lining of CCD is we were able to learn a lot about honeybee health and really make some great strides.
So, problem solved? Not quite. All this news and research and debate concerns that one species, the Western honeybee. And we have a lot of control over the Western honeybee.
Western honeybees are introduced, and so they have been domesticated, and now we treat them at a commercial level a lot like livestock.
Beekeepers breed them by the millions and rent them out to farms and orchards. In some ways, they're more like a fertilizer than an animal. In fact, our mass production of honeybees is the reason we have an almond industry in California.
There's 1 million acres of nut-bearing almonds this year in California. Each one of those acres requires 2 colonies per acre, about. And so that's 2 million colonies that come out here to California just for that event.
For the record, there are maybe 50,000 bees in one colony, so 2 million colonies is about 100 billion bees on almond duty. But here's what so many news reports miss. Honeybees may be doing better, but when it comes to pollination, it's not just about honeybees. Thousands of species of wild bees are key pollinators, and other insects like wasps, butterflies, and beetles play an important role too. Oftentimes, certain pollinators are just better suited to certain crops.
Some of the native pollinators get up earlier, some of them work different aspects of the flower, so having all of them working together ends up being more beneficial for the growers.
And wild pollinators are in trouble. Habitat loss, climate change, and pesticide use are threatening wild pollinators around the world. And when those numbers drop, there's no easy fix. The honeybee population is recovering partly because beekeepers are just breeding more bees or buying them wholesale.
You can buy packaged bees, so a 3-pound, basically box of bees with a mated queen. Those prices range anywhere between $90 and I would say $140, depending on how many you're ordering.
So what is going on with bees? It really depends on the bee.
The western honeybee is not in danger of extinction. There's about 2.7 million colonies in the United States, so their species is not in any sort of trouble. Whereas native bees are affected by the habitat loss and other challenges, and there are species that are endangered. There are species that have become extinct.
Pollination supports between $2 and $6 billion in global agriculture every year. Honeybees are an effort to control and optimize that process, to help feed the 7 billion plus people on Earth. But we clearly don't have the control we want. Wild pollinators are proof of that. So while honeybees may still be struggling, that's not the same thing as being truly threatened.
So when we say we need to save the bees, to me, I would say help honeybees rather than save honeybees.
Hey everyone, thanks for watching, and make sure to subscribe. We've got new videos coming out every Tuesday. And if you find yourself beekeeping and you get a bee in your veil, don't worry, we asked Bernardo about that too.
Turtle your neck, let it fly up, and smash it.